plop down in bed after a night of drinking, only to feel the room spinning wildly around you. You have the dreaded spins. Here's why they happen. Hey, this is Annie for D News. So let's say you had one too many tonight. You stumble onto your bed or the nearest couch to crash, but once you close your eyes, you get the sensation of spinning out of control on the world's least fun merry-go-round. Often along with nausea and double vision that makes it impossible to get the sleep you need. Your options are to wait it out or to wrap yourself in the cold porcelain embrace to rid yourself of the toxins and hopefully get to sleep. Good times. But what causes it? Other than the obvious answer of the 4 shots of Fireball you took tonight, the spins have to do with your inner ear. In there, you have semicircular canals that are filled with a fluid called endolymph and a gelatinous structure called the cupula. In the cupula are cells covered in tiny hairs. This is all called the vestibular system, and it helps to regulate your balance. When you drink a lot, the alcohol thins your blood, and when the inner ear receives this thinned blood, it throws off the density between the fluid and the cupula, causing those tiny hairs to bend artificially. This is what sends that false signal to your brain that you're rotating when you're really not. And guess what, party animals? Mixing booze with weed is often reported as making the spins worse, at least anecdotally, like on this Yahoo Answers thread. But it is proven that alcohol and pot can amplify each other's effects. Interestingly, a 2001 study showed that people who smoked marijuana and then drank ended up with higher THC levels in their blood than those who had just smoked the pot. One explanation is that alcohol causes changes in your blood vessels and increases absorption of the THC. So no, contrary to what that one guy in college might have told you once, smoking weed, if you're drunk, will not actually sober you up. In fact, the two can add up to more than the sum of their parts in terms of your buzz and the consequences you might face later. But let's say it's too late. The room is already spinning, and there you are, lying in bed, too drunk to sleep. Now, there's no direct scientific support for this, but lots of people say that dropping one foot on the ground or on a wall to compensate for that disorientation can help restore your balance and reduce the spins. Breathing deeply, not looking at moving objects, and maybe even throwing up, as unpleasant as that is, might help you to get to sleep faster. But I'm no scientist, just a person who has had the spins before and reads a lot of Yahoo Answers threads. And of course, we're obligated to say, consider not taking that 2 a.m. Fireball shot. Have you ever had this happen before after drinking? Also, be sure to check out our past episodes on the science of hangovers. And as always, let us know your questions and comments on Twitter at DNews or on Facebook at Discovery News. You can also find me on Twitter at Annie Gauss, as well as at my other show, What's the Big Deal? Thanks for watching. See you next time.